It's an absolute honour to have you here with us at FrightFest. Can you tell us how you first got involved in the project?
It was through some mutual friends. Said a guy called Ben had this script knocking around called The Chamber. It's so, there's no exciting story behind it. And asked if he could tell me the script. I read it. And I'd been asked to do a few things before. And I suppose I just, because it's all new to me, I always had one rule. If I read the script in a first sitting, then it meant that, I enjoyed it. And so I got the script off Ben and just read it in one sitting flat. Met up with him. We had really got on. I had the same kind of had the same references. Really just got on. And I thought, well, it's the first time I've actually been asked to do something where I read the script and I just want to keep turning the page. Really got on the director. Hell, it's, at the age of 40, I'm 47 now, but at the age of 46, let's take a chance on something. And I'm really glad I did.
Obviously, you're excited by the script. Can you talk about the musical influences that went into the music you provide?
Yeah, I don't want to try and extemporize around quite simple technical issues. But, the one thing you're aware of when you read a script which is based in a submersible in the ocean is that you have the sonic irony of having a very close environment stuck within a vast environment. You have this submersible, trapped at the bottom of a vast, endless ocean. So you've got to try and achieve, I suppose what I tried to achieve was, I wanted all the echoes, the noises, all the the ephemera of noise that's associated with the submarine. I wanted those noises to feel as if they were being choked, that they wanted to escape, but they were hitting a first wall beyond the ocean. I think that's your first challenge, to try and convey that close space, which is like a Russian doll. It's trapped in a vast space. So, that was the first challenge, I think.